subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates. Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to solve some bits, gate bits, which were asked on determining candidate keys. In our previous class, we have seen how to determine candidate keys. If you haven't watched that video, watch that video. Please watch that video and come back here. There we have taken some examples also. So the previous video of this video, we solved two examples, and before that we have discussed about determining candidate keys. If you haven't watched that video, please watch that video and come back here. Because without understanding the concept of determining candidate keys, it is not possible how we have solved this question. So coming to this question, it was asked in GATE 1999. And let R be, so R is a relation with the following attributes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and they are A, B, C, D, E, F attributes. Be the relation schema with the following functional dependencies. So the following are the functional dependencies. Let's take the functional dependencies separately because it helps us a lot. We are going to understand a small technique. Where we can reduce the number of closures. So in our previous video, we said that there is a small technique by which we can reduce the number of closures. So now these are the functional dependencies. Which of the following is the key of R? So among these, which of the following is a key? So let's find out the solution for this. So what we have to do is, generally what we have to do is, we have to find all the combinations that are possible with the given attribute. So how many attributes are there? There are six attributes. The number of combinations that are possible are 2 power 6 minus 1. Okay. It is around 63. 2 power 6 minus 1 is 63 combinations are there. So we have to find the closure of all the 63 combinations. So is it possible to find closure for all the 63 combinations in 2 minutes or 3 minutes to solve a problem? No, it is not possible. So the best way is to solve this problem is, the technique is this technique is very, very important. The logic of the technique is very, very important. So here what we have to find is, what are the attributes that are not there on the right hand side of the given functional dependencies? So what are the attributes that are not there? So what are the attributes that are there? It is A, B, D, F. And what are the attributes that are not there in the right hand side of the given functional dependencies? A, B, C is not there, E is not there. So these are the attributes that are not there on the right hand side of the given functional dependencies. So the logic is, if some of the attributes are not there on the right hand side of the functional dependencies, we can never determine those attributes unless they are involved in the left hand side. This point is very important to understand. The logic behind this technique is, this is the logic. So the logic is, if the attributes are not there on the right hand side, if the attributes are not there on the right hand side, we can never determine those attributes. We can never determine C and D unless they are there in the left hand side. Unless they are there on the left hand side means in the closure of the combination of attributes, we should definitely have the combination of the attributes C and E. We should definitely have C and E. So for example, if you take C and E, why we should have this C and E definitely in the closure means, if you don't have C and E, we can never get the values of C and E. So in order to find the candidate keys, we should have all the attributes. But we are missing, what are the attributes that are missing on the right hand side? It is C and E. So in order to get C and E on the left hand side, on the combinations that are possible with the attributes, we should take the combinations in such a way that must include the attribute C and E. So C and E should be there. The combinations like CEA, CEB, so these combinations must be involved. Okay, so in the combinations there should be CE. Without CE we cannot get all the attributes, because the attributes CE are not there on the right hand side. Are you able to get the point? That point is very important to understand. If you didn't get that point, please watch that part again and again until you get the idea. So we have to start our first combination with CE. With CE, what are the attributes that we are going to get? So C and E are going to be there. If there is no CE on the left hand side, we are never going to get CE. So we know that we are never going to get CE, but what is the use of finding the closure of that particular combination? We know that CE is not possible, but we should have all the attributes in the closure. But CE is not possible without having CE on the left hand side. Okay, so now CE has been obtained. Now we get this CE determines F. Okay, E determines A, because E is there, E is determining A. EC is determining D. EC is determining D, and A is determining, A is there, yes, A is determining B. So what are the attributes that we have? A, B, C, D, E, F. We got all the attributes that are there in the relation. So now, do we need to find any other combination of attributes? So do we need to do the closure of the remaining combinations with CE? No, there is no need, because anything added to, we must have CE. And anything added to CE is going to be a super key. They are not going to be candidate keys. So this discussion was already made in our previous videos. Please watch those videos. So anything which is added to CE is going to be a super key. But we must have CE. So the only candidate key that is possible is a CE. So the right option is EC. And similarly, this problem can also be solved in the same way. So the given combination, so is it possible to find all the combinations that are possible with these many number of attributes in a given time of 3 to 4 minutes for a bit? No, it is not possible. Just 2 minutes, not only 3 to 4 minutes. So what we have to do is, we have to find what are the attributes that are not there on the right hand side. So what are the attributes that are not there on the right hand side? So these are the functional dependencies given. So from these functional dependencies, the attributes that are not there are G, E is not there. So E is not there. F is not there. G is there. H is not there, I is there, J is there, K is there, L is there, M is there, and N is there. So the only attributes that are not there on the right hand side is E, F, H. Now every combination that we are going to take to find the closure, it should have EFH. Without EFH, it is not possible, because we are not going to have EFH on the right hand side. So that is the reason why we have to take them on the left hand side. The combination should have EFH. So let's find the closure of EFH. What is the closure of EFH? If we are going to get, we are going to get all the attributes with the closure of EFH, we are lucky enough. No need to find the other combinations. If not, we have to find all the combinations. That is, that there is no separate technique for that. We have to find all the combinations which have EFH. Mostly we don't get that kind of bits. If we get that, so there is no other way, we have to find. And if all the attributes are there on the right hand side, then also there is no option. We have to start from one combination, one attribute combination, two attribute combination, three attribute combination. Similarly, how many number of attributes are there, those number of combinations we have to take, and we have to find the closure for everything. Okay, so now EFH, what it is going to generate? We are going to have EFH on the right hand side. EF is going to generate G. F is there. F is going to generate I, J. And next, EH. EH is going to generate KL. K is generating M. So we are going to get all the combinations. So all the attributes we have identified with the closure of EFH. With the closure of EFH, we got all the combination, all the attributes. please check them. So we have all the attributes. So the candidate key for this is EFH. And you may get confused, this also going to get obtained. This is going to obtain. So that is the reason why. So you may go for the, you may go with the option finding the closure of EF. Okay, EFH, it is also going to get. If you find EF, it is not going to get. So if you go with the options and finding the closure, these two will determine all the attributes. If you don't know this concept, this logic, you may get confused which one is the right option. Okay, so the right option is this one, because this is going to be a super key. Anything added to candidate key, anything added to candidate key is a super key. Okay, so that is the logic. That logic is very important to understand. If you are not able to get this logic on a single watch, please watch this as many times as possible until you get the idea. Hope you got the clarity on these concepts and you understood these bits. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.